Selim. Good morning. I am Mrs. Barahu, teacher of English at Alta School, of course. So, my pupils, this is the lesson one about grammar lesson, okay? We are going to deal with must and mustn't, obligation. When I say you must, it means you are obliged to. You have to do something. And when I say mustn't, it expresses prohibition. It means forbidden. You haven't to do it, to deal with it. Okay? When I say you must, it means you have to. You have to. So must expresses obligation and mustn't expression prohibition. The synonym, the equivalent of must is has to. When we have she or he, we have to use has to. And when we have they or plural or I say I must. It means I have to. And I mustn't the same. I mustn't. It's forbidden. It means I haven't to do. You haven't to do. They haven't to do. We haven't to do. We haven't. It's forbidden. You mustn't, okay? And mustn't, it means, is the synonym of must not. Must not, must not, it means mustn't, okay? Here you have some examples. You must revise your lesson. You must. You are obliged. You have, okay, to revise your lesson. You have to revise your lesson. When I say you must, oblige, no discussion. Second example, children must obey their parents. Or children have to obey their parents. The third example, pupils must respect their teacher. They are obliged, they have to respect. The subject is at the infinitive, okay? They have to respect, to revise, to obey. The fourth one, you mustn't make noise in class. You mustn't, okay? It's forbidden. You haven't to make noise, okay? The synonym of must, we say, the synonym of must is have to, and the synonym of mustn't is haven't to. The fifth example, Rima must do her homework. Rima must do her homework. Okay? It means Rima has to do her homework. Rima must do her homework. It means Rima has to do her homework. Yes? Alors, so, my rule is subject plus must plus verb. The example is Amel is a subject. Must write her lesson. Write, verb. Amel must write her lesson. Okay. For the second one, for mustn't, subject plus mustn't plus verb. Here the example is Kamal mustn't smoke cigarettes. Mustn't. Kamal subject, mustn't. Here you are mustn't. Verb, smoke cigarettes. We get Kamal mustn't smoke cigarettes. Okay? This is my rule about must and mustn't. I hope that you understand, my pupil, okay? Is there any question? I wait for your question, yes. Yes, and we have also must with question, interrogative form. We have this form. Must pupil come early to school? Here we have to answer with yes or no. If it is yes, it's okay. It means must. If it is no, it mustn't. Must. So, must pupil come early to school? Yes, they must. Yes, Yes, they must. Yes, because we have yes. We put must because we have yes. Must people speak in class? Jawed, try to answer, please. Yes? Yes, Mohand? Yes, good. No, they mustn't. No, they mustn't. They mustn't speak. It means they mustn't. Because we have no, it's negative form, we have mustn't. Alors, mustn't is used for prohibition and must for obligation. Keep it in your mind. It's okay? Alors, next time we are going to revise must and mustn't, okay? Then we are going to deal with practice. I'll kiss you. Bye. Yes, bye.